Okay, hi everyone, welcome back to another video. Today's video is actually kind of a special video. It's not a review or anything. I am in front of the camera for a little bit. It is actually my 7th year on YouTube. It's my 7th YouTube anniversary. It's actually tomorrow, but I'm doing this video today just because in case I'm busy and don't have time tomorrow to do it. So I wanted to do this today. December 23rd, 2011, I technically rejoined YouTube. I actually had another channel, and it was a channel, it wasn't the best channel. I only had like 100, maybe 200 subscribers. It's gone now, so I couldn't tell you. And I got an email saying, do you want a partnership? And stupid me fell for it. And so I did fall for it, unfortunately. And my channel was hacked. I was so upset because to me, 100 to 200 subscribers was a lot. And I felt like I was getting somewhere on YouTube. So I wasn't going to make another channel. I wasn't going to do it again. And I was just going to give up. But I decided to make the 101 Jenko channel, which is the channel you're watching now. And I just said, you know what, it's not going to be like my other channel. It's just going to be, no one's going to watch my videos, no one's going to subscribe, whatever. Well, my channel since then has come a long, long way, thanks to you guys, and stuff like that. And it's better than my old channel. It's better. I have over 2,000 subscribers, which blows my mind, like, I just want to say a big, big thank you to all of you. Without you guys, I would not be here. I do this for fun. I don't make money off my videos or anything. I like being, there's a place that I could give my opinions and thoughts about certain toys, certain Funko Pops, movies, you name it. My channel, even though the ground base for my channel was Star Wars, because I love Star Wars, I like to do many different things for my channel. So today I thought I would give you guys an apartment tour collection update, just because I couldn't think of anything else besides that or Q&A. And the last time I did a Q&A, I didn't get very many questions. So I'll do one of those in the future again, but probably not for a while. So we're going to start off in my room, and then we'll make our way out in the living room and stuff. So I am using my camera. Unfortunately, I did try my phone here, but it only gave me like 5 minutes of recording. So I'm going to try to, as you can see, I am actually using my phone light. I'm going to try to hold my phone and film at the same time to give you light. That way it's not horrible, because the camera I'm using isn't the best. I really need to upgrade in camera. I really need to do an upgrade in a camera with a light, because this doesn't have a light. It's an older camera. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to actually pause, and we will be right back with the collection video. Okay, and we are back with the collection video. First, we are going to start off with the Star Wars figure collection. That's where kind of my channel, that's where the roots are of my channel. I'm a fan of many, many different things, but Star Wars kind of started my channel, and we're going to start off with the figures. The lighting is not that great. I'm using this kind of lantern thing, because this camera is not that great. So, I'm just going to go over the figures. Up here is my Episode 1 and 2 collection. Phantom Menace and Attack of the Clones. And we're just gonna go through the figures. Not the best lighting, I know. It is 7:30 here, so it's dark. But you guys, if you guys are new to my channel, or if you've been following my channel for a while now, you guys know I am a big Star Wars prequel fan. I love all the movies, but the prequels are my favorite part of the saga. I thought they were really good movies, and I know they're not for everyone, but I like them. And here's Phantom Menace collection. And yeah, so I think we got all that. And then right next to it, we have Attack of the Clones, which is my personal favorite Star Wars movie. I know it's most people's least favorite Star Wars movie, but I did like the romance between Anakin and Padme, and also like the big battle at the end. It was pretty cool. And then we get down here, which is not a movie, it was a TV show, and it's coming back, and it's The Clone Wars. And I did not finish The Clone Wars. I wanted to, but I just did not finish it. But I've seen the mostly the episodes with Padme in them. Back there we have a couple realistic figures of Anakin and Padme, another Padme and Anakin, Obi-Wan, and Darth Maul. I really need to upgrade a camera. And then we get to the good guys are right here. Then we get into the bad guys, the villains. And then we get to the Episode 3, Revenge of the Sith, which is the saddest Star Wars movie, in my opinion, because just the death of Padme, the rise of the Empire, the death of the Jedi, all very sad. Even though I'm a pretty big Palpatine fan, it's still sad to see him kind of take over as the evil guy. But there's Episode 3. Then we get down to Rebels, Rogue One, and Solo. Here is Rebels right there. You can kind of see Ahsoka, Leia, the two other guys, Vader. And then we get to Rogue One. And then we get to Solo, and my only Solo figure right now is Kira. I did see Solo a couple weeks ago. It was alright. It wasn't bad. I think I liked Rogue One a little better. But then we get to A New Hope, which is technically the first Star Wars movie. And A New Hope then became Episode 4. And then we get to Empire, Episode 5. I wish I could just hang this here. Which is most people's favorite Star Wars movie. Like I said, I love all the Star Wars movies. My favorite is Attack of the Clones up there. And then we get to Episode 6. Right there. And along with Episode 6 is a little expanded universe. And then Force Awakens. And then Last Jedi is mostly all that. I had the BB-8 playset out where that Snoke figure came from, but I actually put that away just because I didn't have much room. And then down here we just have a couple dolls from Forces of Destiny, a couple other ones, and then, whoa. We have some magazines and books behind them, and VHS tapes, and that's a watch right here, and stuff like that. So there's that. I'm actually going to get up and move on to the next part of the collection. Okay, up here are these 12-inch figures, I think that they are. You can get them in stores. Well, you can't get Anakin and Jin anymore, or that Rey. I don't think you can get any of these in stores anymore. Maybe some stores, but I have Anakin, Jin, and the two Reys. I have the little Rey figure there. And then we get onto my Funko Pops of Star Wars. And we're just gonna go right into it. And I'm not gonna name them off. I'll name off my favorites. And one of my favorites would be the Queen Amidala there. It's actually my favorite pop in my whole collection. It's just such a beautiful pop. Really like the Emperor Palpatine pop. The Hoth Leia pop's really nice. Aayla Secura. Of course, the Padme Amidala. Akira. The rays are nice as well. And then we get down. I like the Snoke pop, of course, and the Princess Leia one right there. And then my Jyn Erso's. I actually had more Rogue One pops, but earlier this year I did get rid of some. I just kept the Jyns and the Darth Vader. And then we have my Star Wars Attack of the Clones poster. And then we have another poster. We have a 1999 Toy Fair poster. We have a Dorito bag with Anakin and Padme on it. We have Hot Wheels. I have all the prequel Hot Wheels. Phantom Menace. Attack of the Clones. And Revenge of the Sith. Then I have character cards. I have Leia and Darth Vader. And then I have a Leia pin. A Queen Amidala pin. A Episode 1 3D pin. And these are card sleeves right there. And I have some more pins. And then I have a Snoke and Kylo Hot Wheels set. I got it because Snoke was in it. I'm not a fan of Kylo, so. Then a couple cards. I have a Palpatine puzzle. A Snoke card. These things that came with some of the Power of the Force figures. Then a cover right there of the prequels. I just have a couple pictures here that actually, these pictures go there. I just took them down. I have this Snoke cardboard cutout that I framed. I wanted to keep it safe. I have one of my mom, one of my friends and I, Shani Wanna Says Nancy, and one of my old dog that I lost, earlier this year as well. And then my Star Wars stamps. And then we are gonna go and take a look at there. Next we have my carded Padme Amidala figures. Padme is really the only character I get all of the figures loose and carded of. I'm so excited for the Star Wars The Black Series Padme figure because I'm planning to get two of her. Oops. And so I have all of the 3-inch Hasbro figures, and I'm just going to go through them like this and show you them. I'm not going to name them because last time I did that just took too long. You guys can see, them for yourselves, and I did many videos of them on my channel, so you guys can check those videos out. There's more. I have all of them, even the repacks, because I love Padme. Sorry if the glare is kind of bad on some of them. And my Black Series one will go right there where the Dreamcatcher is. And then up here, which I was saving to when I showed my, carded Padme figures. I have the Battle Packs Padme came in. I have the Arena Encounter. Poor Battle Pack is kind of falling apart on me, but there she is right there. It comes with Anakin, Obi-Wan, and the creatures. This is the next two. And then I have the Ambush on Elm that Padme's in. And then R2-D2 and C-3PO are in it. And then some droids. Then I have this pack. It's Jabba's Rain Carpet. Can't really see it. Let me get the light. That's a little better, but the glare is pretty bad. It comes with Leia, C-3PO, Jabba, Luke, and the Rancor. And then up there is the Evolutions of Padme Amidala set that comes with the Queen Amidala and then the Episode 3 Padme. And then right here, I didn't show this. It's the Blu-ray it's a digital release pack. Comes with Padme, Darth Maul, Battle Droid, and R2-D2. And then I have some ornaments. I have two Lego Planets of Tatooine and Naboo over there. And then I also have carded Disney Infinity Chewbacca. Can't really see him, but he is there. And then I have Luke and Leia carded too. Just trying to get the Star Wars stuff all in one. This is not all my Star Wars stuff. Some is out in the living room. Then I do have some other carded figures. I have Clone Wars Aayla Secura. This is the first release. Blue Lightsaber Chancellor Palpatine. And then those Leias. And then my two Snoke figures, which were both repacks. But I really, really love this card. Very, very nice card. He should still be in stores. You still could find him. Maybe him too. And then we are going to go down to the show. Actually, I don't even need to pause. We have right here my Padme shelf. I will go back to the other collections. And then we have my 6-inch Black Series shelf right there with Darth Vader kind of hanging out on Snoke's throne. I have little scenes set up, like Snoke using the Force on Rey, Palpatine telling Vader to rise, the interrogation scene between Leia, Vader, and Tarkin, and just some other stuff. That is not a Black Series, that's the Disney Elite Series Snoke figure. And then we will go back up here because that was the last of the Star Wars, and I do have some Wizard of Oz items. I love Wizard of Oz, but my mom really liked Wizard of Oz too. So I do have a Wizard of Oz shelf. And then a Battle Droid watch right there. Then I have Walking Dead. To be fair, I haven't caught up with Walking Dead. I don't really have any interest to right now, just because all my favorite characters are dead, and yeah. But there's Walking Dead. I have some autographs there of Sarah Wayne Callies, Laurie Holden, and Melissa McBride. I just did my Walking Dead collection, so we're not going to spend too much time. And then I have my Lord of the Rings shelf, which I love the first three Lord of the Rings movies. They are amazing. Beautifully shot. And then right here we have some my Rock Candy collection. And then a Jason Voorhees and Freddy Krueger vinyl pack right there. And then I just have some of my books on the bottom shelf. Right here I have some of my other Star Wars pops. And just some other little plushes and itty bitties. And I have this Leia Elite Series. I have another one down on the other shelf. And just other Funko Pops, more bigger, and you know, the packs and stuff like that. And then down here we're gonna take a look at that. We have some of my Snow White and the Seven Dwarfs collection, my posters, keychains, stuff like that, art. And then we have my Funko Pops of Snow White, and I included Once Upon a Time because they are Snow White characters. After Christmas, I plan to do a Funko Pop update, so I'm not sure how because I've gotten quite a bit, but there they are. And then a Snow White ornament pack right there. And then some other Funko Pops are in here. My closet is just a mess. We have some Disney packs. The other Disney Pops are out there, which I will show you. And just kind of Game of Thrones and Batman and some Harry Potter. Some live-action Disney, Mary Jane, some Stranger Things, some Supernatural. and then some Lost and Alien and just some other random ones right there too. And my Ariel and Maleficent, this camera. I am really wanting to get a new camera. And then we have some other, now this table I usually keep blank because that's where I take pictures, but we have a Snow White figure pack, my Baby Evil Queen plush, and my my Evil Queen lunchbox. And this box was my mom's, but it reminded me of the Evil Queen heart box. And then we just have some frame pictures there. And right there. Then we have my card binder. I'm not gonna go through it right now just because it will take a long time, but that is my card binder. I might do a separate video on that, and there's that. And then the last couple things are my Beauty and the Beast pops and stuff like that. And other figures. That is the original yellow dress Belle. Some Dorbs, the Funko Pops, I have all of the live action and animated Beauty and the Beast Pops, got some Budgens right there on top of a Belle Cup, got a Lego Castle, the Beast Castle right there with Belle and Beast dancing, cup right there, and then we have my Once Upon a Time poster. And we have my 31-inch Vader and Big Figs Jyn Erso. So that's really it in the room. Oh, forgot to mention my Lori Grimes poster. We have my Lori Grimes poster. The glare is so bad. I know you're probably watching this like, why do I like Lori Grimes? I thought she was amazing and great character, and I love Sarah Wayne Callies and Lori. And then we have my Lori buttons and a poker chip. And Hello Kitty, Rick and Lori, and some Sarah Wayne Callies and Lori keychains. That's Jesse, not Lori. And then we have some dog tags right there, and some other necklaces. Almost forgot that part. And then my Wicked Witch Funko Pop is up there with the Zelina, and my Lori Grimes art prints up there. So let's move on to another part of the house. Right here we have, we're in the hallway, we have my Oliver poster. Oliver is one of my favorite movies. And this was in Italian, I think. It's a Princess Leia comic that my sister got to me when she went to Italy. I have all the Leia comics in English, so I framed it because it's not in English. Right here we have, I made this for my mom a long time ago in school, and my mom was a painter, so, and as you guys know, she passed in 2016, so I have a lot of her stuff up. Then we have, I don't think I need the light anymore, my Snow White shelf, with just a bunch of Snow White, Evil Queen, stuff on it. And here are my Snow White figures. This was a childhood Christmas ornament. My Snow White figures. We got Evil Queen, Snow White, Prince Charming, the Seven Dwarfs. The only figure I would love to have at least one of is the Huntsman, and I don't have a Huntsman figure. But there they are. Then we move up down to some dolls. Other things, mostly dolls down here, more figures, a motion globe of the Evil Queen, and then some random more figures on the shelf. That is a makeup bag, that is a glass behind a card, and just more. I really gotta do my shelves. And then we have some more figures right here. That is a knockoff Snow White doll right there. Right there. And then we will go and move on to some other parts. Right here is where we start my Disney Funko Pops. I am in the kitchen. And I have I have stuff on top of the cabinets, but we have some stuff in front of the pops there. You might not be able to see the Funko Pops that great, but again, I'm gonna do a collection video up there. More of my mom's paintings. Her ashes are right there. More of the paintings. And so on and so forth. And just some more Snow White stuff. My two Regina statues and action figure, or aka Evil Queen. And then we're gonna move on to over there. And then we more Funko Pops up there. We have more Snow White and Evil Queen stuff. And then we move on to the last of my Disney Pops up here. More. I do have a Narnia collection, but it's put away right now, so those are the only figures that are out. And then we have the end of my Disney Pops. Up here is where my Horror Pops start, with my American Horror Story Pops. I have two. And then we're gonna actually move the chair that I'm standing. That might help. Then we have my Fiona Good doll. I love Fiona Good. Love Jessica Lange. My Michael Myers 12-inch figure. My Pamela Voorhees sideshow. And then one of those cloth Jason Voorhees. And behind them are all my Horror Pops. Trying to show you them. And then over there we have a Night of the Living or Day of the Living Dead Pennywise doll, along with more Horror Pops. And that's really it for up here. Let me know what you thought. And then we are gonna move down there. Okay, so this is where I keep my DVDs. I have some horror plushes right here. Freddy is falling asleep on Pennywise. And then my DVDs are right here in Blu-rays, and we're just going to go through them like I did the other stuff. We're not going to, name off names. You guys can read, and you guys know the names pretty well. So right there. And horror movies. I have a Dean plush right there with more DVDs and stuff like that. This is my TV shows are right here mostly. And here are my Blu-rays. I need another DVD rack. I don't know where I'm gonna put it, but I need it. And then behind me is my mom was also a, she loves to take pictures. This is where I used to live, around there. There I am, that's baby me. That's my mom when she was a little girl. There's another picture she took. And then two more paintings that she painted. Right here is my Jurassic shelf. Jurassic is one of my newer passions that I got into this year. And of course, when I get into something, I have to have it, collect it. And here we are. I love Blue. Blue is my favorite dinosaur. I love a lot of the dinosaurs, but Blue is, I find Blue very adorable. We have Mosasaurus, Dominus Rex, and other dinosaurs. We have Claire right there, the second release of Claire. Claire is my favorite character, of course. We have my Funko Pops. We have my Lego set. This was actually a Christmas gift, an early one. And then we just have figures. We have the two Ellie and Alan figures. We have Zia over there. A Blue, this is the battle. The battle damage one. We have Maisie, Claire, and Owen. And just more. Another Blue. I also love Stiggy. His scene, regardless, were funny in the movie and very adorable. Triceratops. We have the Jurassic Park Jeep with Muldoon and Malcolm in it. Then down here is my Batman collection. We have my Dark Knight trilogy stuff right here. Back there is my custom Rachel Dawes. Then we have more of the video game comic book style Batman figures. We have some keychains. Then down here is one of my favorite shelves, is actually, and it is my horror shelf. I love horror movies. We have down there, I framed my ticket from when I saw Halloween. This year, I thought it was a good memory. And then down here we have my Beauty and the Beast shelf, which is, Belle is my second favorite Disney princess, but Beauty and the Beast is my third favorite Disney movie. And then down here we have some of my Marvel Spider-Man figures. They are actually all Spider-Man figures. Mary Jane, Doc Ock, Spider-Man. Then we have some of my 101 Dalmatians collection. Some of the figures fell over there. But we have Cruella. We have Cruella. We have a Cruella right here. And Roger and Horace. And more of that. And then we have some of my Hunchback of Notre Dame figures. Great movie. And that is that shelf. And then over here we have some It figures carded. I've actually taken them out. Some figures and ornaments there. Then we have some X-Men figures right here. And then in here we have my Sleeping Beauty, Little Mermaid, and down there you can't really see is my Cinderella figures. Not gonna move all this stuff, but we have Ariel and Eric right there. And yeah. And then we, right there is an image of my mom back in her younger days. She was only 55 when she passed, but she must have been like 20-something maybe there. Then behind there we have my Shani Wallace autographs. And then behind her that my mom drew Nancy for me for my 22nd birthday. And then over here we just have some Star Wars stuff. We have my mystery mini case. I'm all complete. I got all the mystery minis I wanted. Until at least. And then some Palpatine stuff right there. Some Leia stuff right there. And some plushes. And some Disney figures. This is my pint-sized heroes case with Snow White and the Seven Dwarfs. I have all the Snow White ones. And I have all the first series ones because I went crazy trying to find Belle and I couldn't, and I had to buy her online. So I did end up getting the whole series. And then we have some Disney mystery minis. We have the live action Beauty and the Beast one, and then some other ones. And these fell, but we have some It mystery minis. It is actually one of my favorite remakes. I thought it was pretty good. And yeah, so that's all that. Right here we have my Batman animated collection from the animated TV series and the four villains from the live action movies. We have some villains, Batman, Batgirl and Robin, Joker and Harley, Two-Face, Ra's al Ghul, Scarecrow, like all that. And I think that might be it. I think I forgot to show that. My Leia and Rey Disney Infinity figures and my A-list Akira stuff right there. And that was my entire collection update. Let me know your thoughts down below. I know the lighting was bad. I'm sorry I don't have the best camera. I do need to upgrade cameras though. Again, thank you so much for 7 years. You guys have been great. Let me know your thoughts down below. And I'm not sure if I'll do a video before Christmas. Probably not, because Christmas is Tuesday and Christmas Eve is Monday, and tomorrow I'll probably be busy with laundry and stuff. And so let me know your thoughts. What do you think of my collection? What was your favorite part? Do you collect any of this stuff? Let me know all that down below. Please subscribe to my channel. All my information is down below. Have a Merry Christmas, and in case if I don't do a video before New Year's, have a Happy New Year as well. Thank you for watching. Please subscribe to my channel and have a great day. Bye. Okay, you guys made it to the end of the video. Thank you for watching. I hope you guys enjoyed the video. Remember, you guys can follow me on the social media links I have in my channel and down below. And I also do have a fan mail address if you would like to send fan mail. Feel free to do so, and I hope you guys enjoyed this review. Please subscribe to my channel and have a great day. Bye. Max. Hi. Happy holidays for Max. What? You can go back to sleep. You can go back to sleep. Someone likes tummy rubs. Happy holidays for Max.